Hello everyone, my name is Francois, and today I'm going to show you how to set up your VoiceMeeter application with StreamYard. VoiceMeeter is a virtual audio mixer that exists virtually on your computer. In combination with StreamYard, you'll be able to get some of the best streaming experience by gaining full audio control on your desktop and sending it out to StreamYard to be distributed to the world for all your streaming needs. In this video, we're gonna quickly set up the VoiceMeeter application on our desktop. Then we're going to set up our microphone in the VoiceMeeter application so that it can be sent through VoiceMeeter into StreamYard. Using VoiceMeeter and StreamYard in combination, you will get the ultimate control of the audio on your computer, and that will optimize the overall experience of your streams. In this video, we're gonna be strictly sticking to the desktop audio and the microphone audio within VoiceMeeter. In future videos, we're gonna be doing some more creative things with VoiceMeeter and StreamYard. So if you're interested in content like that, make sure you like this video and subscribe to this YouTube channel. There are three versions of VoiceMeeter in total. You have the VoiceMeeter base version, VoiceMeeter Banana, and VoiceMeeter Potato. VoiceMeeter Potato is the biggest application of the three. VoiceMeeter Potato is free to use. However, it does have a pop-up system asking you to donate every 6 hours. In order to remove the pop-up, you'll need to donate to the software. VoiceMeeter Banana is going to be the biggest of the three that is absolutely free. So, in this video, we're going to be looking at VoiceMeeter Banana. If you're interested in more inputs and outputs on the VoiceMeeter application, consider taking a look at VoiceMeeter Potato. In order to download the VoiceMeeter application, we'll need to go to vb-audio.com and we'll navigate our way to the Audio Apps tab. There, we'll go to the Banana tab since we're looking for the VoiceMeeter Banana application. There will be a link in the description below that will navigate you to this page. If you scroll down, what we're looking for is that .exe file. So go ahead and hit the install for that .exe file. Once the .exe file has downloaded, go ahead and run that .exe file to install VoiceMeeter Banana to your desktop. After VoiceMeeter Banana has been successfully installed, we can go ahead and open up the application from our Windows Start menu. So if you type in here VoiceMeeter Banana, the application will pop up. Go ahead and run that application. When you open up VoiceMeeter for the first time, this is what it's going to look like. The first thing we need to do is select our output device. You'll find the hardware outputs in the A1 through A3 selections here. This is going to be actual hardware that's on our desktop. So things like headphones, speakers, Bluetooth speakers, that sort of stuff. We're going to select the A1 device. Make sure you select your main source. So I'm going to go ahead and select my speakers, which is actually going to be my headphones because I have them hooked up to my speakers. The next thing we're going to do is set up our microphone within the VoiceMeeter application. We can do this in the hardware input section on the app. We're going to go ahead and set up our microphone on the hardware input 1. So go ahead and select your input now. To make your life easier, we can go ahead and change the label of the hardware input. All you need to do is right click on that label and go ahead and change it to microphone. The next thing I want to have you guys do is deselect the A1 source on your microphone and then go ahead and switch from B1 over to B2. You can also deselect B1 on all of these other sources, and we'll talk more about that later. The next thing we want to set up is our desktop audio within the VoiceMeeter app. Now, if you don't want to use VoiceMeeter as your main audio routing source, then you can skip this portion of the video, but I highly suggest separating all the audio you have on your computer and sending it to VoiceMeeter. So that includes your desktop audio. And the way we do this is by right-clicking the speaker icon down here, going to the sound settings, and then we're going to open the sound control panel. Once the sound control panel opens up, we're going to scroll down on the playback tab till we find the VoiceMeeter input. Go ahead and click the VoiceMeeter input and set that as our default source. After you do that, you can hit OK. What we have just done is sent all of the desktop audio, so all the audio on our computer is going to go to this VoiceMeeter VIO source on VoiceMeeter. So if you right click this, we can go ahead and change the label of that to desktop. That way we know that all the desktop audio is on that source. You'll want to make sure the A1 source here is toggled. This means it is sending this audio to your headphones. The next thing we want to do is set the default microphone source on our computer to be the output source that we send our microphone through on VoiceMeeter. So going back to the sound control panel, we're going to go over to the recording tab. we're gonna scroll down till we find the VoiceMeeter aux output. As you can tell, it's lighting up because that is our B2 source on VoiceMeeter. If you select that source and set it as your default, then you can go ahead and hit okay. When you do this, it will make the default recording device or the default input device on any application on your computer that B2 source on the VoiceMeeter application. So anything that you send to the B2 source will be sent through that input on all of your applications. In this case, we're sending our microphone to that B2 source, and then we're going to set up that source as our microphone on StreamYard. So now we're ready to go over to our StreamYard broadcast and set up our audio sources. Now that we're on our StreamYard broadcast, we can navigate to the cam and mic settings. We'll go to the audio tab. Here, what we want to do is select the default source for our microphone. If the default source is not showing VB-Audio VoiceMeeter Aux Vio, go ahead and manually select the VoiceMeeter Aux output source, which would be this source. Those two are the same. Ideally, you'll just select the default source. Same with the speakers. The speakers, you want to select the default source. If it is not showing the VoiceMeeter input VB-Audio VoiceMeeter Vio, which in my case it is not, it's showing the virtual audio cable, go ahead and manually select the VoiceMeeter Vio source. I want to quickly summarize the setup for you guys. What we've done is set up our microphone in this hardware input 1, and we've sent that to our VoiceMeeter aux output B2, which we set up as our microphone source on StreamYard. In StreamYard, we set the speaker to the VoiceMeeter Vio source, which is going to be this desktop source, which we also set as the default playback source on our computer. We want to make sure we're sending that audio to our A1 source, which is going to be our headphones, our speakers, whatever your main audio source for your hardware output is, so that you can hear that audio for yourself. That's going to conclude the setup of VoiceMeeter with StreamYard. If you guys have any further questions regarding the setup, make sure you leave those in the comments below. If you guys have any interesting ideas or thoughts on how you would utilize this application with StreamYard, make sure you leave those in the comment section below as well. If you guys enjoyed this video, make sure you hit that like button and subscribe to the channel. We have a whole playlist coming out dedicated specifically to VoiceMeeter and ways you can utilize it with StreamYard. I want to thank you guys so much for watching this video, and I will catch you in the next one. Peace.